السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus, the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri Rahmatullahi Alayh.
Lesson number 794. Let us first listen to some advice. And there is something which is exceptionally and very important for in our own life, that we let us not make somebody else's life hell and misery, then we fall down to sajda and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for heaven. This is something which is very foolish. You're making people's life a misery, you're making people's life hell, and thereafter you fall into sajda and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for paradise. This is something which is very, very foolish. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hazrat Buraida radiallahu ta'ala an narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that the murder of a fellow Muslim brother in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is worse than this world coming to an end. This hadith is made mention of in Nasa'i Sharif, meaning that how in the eyes of people the greatest calamity to befall upon them is the end of this world, which is inevitably temporary. But in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the killing and the murdering of a Muslim is something which is even more severe. Sometimes in anger we plan to kill somebody. Sometimes a husband wants to kill his wife. Sometimes a wife is planning to kill the husband. Sometimes they're scheming and they're trying to poison each other. In the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is a grave sin. Be very wary of the rights of people. Let it never be that we fall short when it comes to fulfilling the rights of other people. And thus in no madhab, in no religion, in no sect is it permissible to be able to go and kill and murder another person. Remember something Morana makes mention of, that if a person starts getting the wish and the desire to do wrong, then some sort of haram food must have entered the stomach for such thoughts to come. And when a person gets the inclination towards doing good, then some halal food must have come to the person's stomach. Now let us read inshallah. La ilaha illallahu wahdahu لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. Look, I have read this here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy. The sky towards the heaven, the doors towards the heavens have opened up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attention is towards that person that is reciting. We will receive reward for this year. And the creation, because of passing out some knowledge, will make dua for me. So you want this reward? You also read it inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the same reward. We make dua that, oh Allah, grant us and our progeny halal food. Oh Allah, save us and our progeny from halal. Oh Allah, let it not be such that some good has come upon us because the dealings of some fasiq and some fajir, some person who has done wrong deeds, and some person who is disobedient to you, O Allah. O Allah, let peace and tranquility traverse the earth and keep us all in a happy state and save us from the deception of the devil and our carnal desire. Ameen, ameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.